What up, YouTube?
What up, YouTube?
Damn. Today's video, we're going to talk about RFID chips and how to get rid of demons, part two. Damn, we might have to scoot over that a little bit. That way for them. Like that. All right. Like I was saying on the first part, how to get rid of demons before I was rudely interrupted. What you really got to do is get some sage or some shit like that, like some sage, and burn that bitch, and you chant whatever you want to chant, and that should get rid of the demons because of the smoke. And then it's a whole lot of ways to get rid of demons. Take a salt bath, like get you any type of salt. Salt get rid of demons too. Cause it's like in the olden days, like I say, like BC, you know what BC really mean, right? Yeah. People say before Christ, they really mean before conscious.
Before conscious.
Niggas don't know about that, man. And AD mean after death, I think. Yeah, some shit like that. After death, might be some shit before that, but. Yeah. Take a salt bath, that should get rid of demons.
Back in the medieval days?
Yeah, nah, farther than that. Way farther than that. But, like, take a salt bath, because, like, what our ancestors did, like, they, like, trapped the demons. They used to put the demons inside the pig, and they used to put salt in the pig, because salt keeps demons trapped. That's why you don't really supposed to eat pork, because you know it got demon spirits in it. But that's a whole different story. But that's a way you can get rid of demons, too, by taking a salt bath, Epsom salt, regular salt. The salt you put on snow, all type of shit. Like, the salt, it get rid of demons.
They got pink salt, sea salt, all that shit.
Yellow salt, all
any type
of shit.
Salt, right?
Like, if you got a demon problem, because, like you said, demons in your crib and shit.
Yeah,
like,
not no more, though. I haven't seen them off right here. Minute.
Frequency must be high.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, I want to say something about that. Yeah, the frequency's high in my crib. Now I got my OG eating, not eating too much meat now. Like, she's trying to eat, like, healthy, like, fish and shit. Hell yeah, good frequencies in my house. She's still kind of tweaking, though, but yeah.
Nah, they tweaking in my crib. They ain't even listening.
They ain't getting messages, man.
Yeah, they don't even care about the fruit, man.
Cause they seen, OG must have seen me, like, why he ain't eating, like, churning shit like that? So they guess, like, yeah, if he ain't eating this shit, I'm finna stop, like, at least, like, tone it down. You know that you can't really stop fully eating the meat, so they probably, like, toned it down a little bit.
And plus, you know how people are nowadays, they gonna hit you with the I'm grown, I'm doing what I want. But that's true, though. Mm-hmm. You can do what you want, cause it's free will. If we ain't have free will, niggas would be eating meat all their life.
Right? But it's like, I ain't even tell my OG not to eat. I guess she just saw me and be like, since he eating good, it's like leading by example, not saying no words. She just saw me and be like, yeah, I'ma just follow him. Not really follow, but you know, be on the same side as him.
Nah, that's actually a good thing.
With the seafood.
There's people actually on my Instagram that's like, there's these people called the Conscious Couple. I guess it was like this girl, she was like, I just did a challenge with my mom to get her to eat, like, go vegetarian for like a week or something to see how she like it, which is pretty good, because once you start eating good, you start feeling how the energy is, you basically hooked, because, like, fruit got its own little natural sugars and stuff like that. And that's another way to get rid of demons, too. Like, if your vibration high, they can't touch you. Only way demons can touch you, like I said, if you're on a low frequency, thinking demonic thoughts, doing demonic things, stuff like that, like, that's the only way demons can get you. Or, if you got holes in your aura field, like I said, drinking liquor, eating the bad foods.
Processed food, shit like that.
Speaking down on people, that type of stuff. Even smoking weed, too, though. Even though I love the Chiba, but niggas gotta start making those space cakes, man. Nah, no bullshit. But, like, if you got a demon problem, man, you just gotta get yourself right. Your motherfucker snatching souls left and right. Like, you ever seen this movie called Wishmaster?
But I remember you telling me about it.
Yeah, that Wishmaster is a perfect example of how demons can get you. It's like, it start off like, it's like a sorcery dude. He making like a big ass, like a real ruby. He's making a real ruby from natural elements of the earth. It's funny how they keep going back to nature for this stuff, but ain't nobody peeping it out. So it's like, they trap this demon in this ruby. Basically, yeah, they trap this demon in this ruby. And it's like, if you rub the ruby 3 times, or if you wish for something, the genie come out, like the genie comes out, like it's like a genie in the bottle, but it's like a genie in the ruby and shit.
Yeah.
And it's like, whatever you wish for, the wishmaster gonna reverse your word against you and give you what you asked for, but in an evil way.
Oh, I feel what you
So it's like, you be like, I wish I had money. He's like, okay, I'll give you money, but you gonna die, end up dying.
Like, see, like, I did see some shit.
Like,
kinda
like he, like, swole as hell. He got big ass braids. Braids is like snakes and shit.
Yeah, I remember seeing, like, the same thing. Like, this dude, they were making a wish and shit. Yep. But he fucked up his word, like, using some reverse psychology on the good words and shit and flipping that shit around. Motherfucker, like, damn.
But you can't get around that, though. Like, in the movie Wishmaster, it's like, you gotta say your words, like, you gotta know, you gotta say it, you gotta say it, like, what's that word? you got to be specific with your words. Like, you have to really be specific. Like, this one dude, I forget which one it was, but it was one, I think it was Wishmaster 2. It was a dude, it was in the office, and he asked for, like, some more money or something like that, but dude said it in a slick way, so the Wishmaster couldn't steal his soul right away. He couldn't kill him, because dude knew what he was talking about. But then dude slipped up and said some more stuff, and the Wishmaster got his soul and killed him. But that's basically what I'm saying. It's like, that's they telling you how demons can get you. Like, if you wish for someone, I wish I had a boyfriend, I wish I had a girlfriend, the genie gonna get you, because, like, demons, they can get your thoughts telepathically, because, like, demons is really angels. Demons really mean angels. Look up the etymology. They just follow angels that went a different path. Like, they just, like, they just went to the dark path. Like, yeah, they angels.
Bad angels, but bad angels.
Like, they got powers and stuff. They're just not stronger than, like, the Sirius Sun children. Like, we the Sirius Sun children, because, like, we come from Sirius. Not everybody's soul comes from Sirius, but a lot of souls come from Sirius. A lot of people don't get this type of stuff. And a lot of these demons know where your soul comes from. That's why they own you. Like, before we reincarnate back into this world or incarnate, we do these soul contracts. I don't know if you ever heard of that. Like, you do a soul contract. Like, you, like, sign, like, you, like, make a deal with the Most High. And then, like, you make a deal with the, like, not the devil. I ain't gonna say the devil, but you make a deal with the demons too.
Now, I heard of that, like, in, like, on, like, TV, like, with, what's that dude name? With the Skull, Fiery Skull and shit. It's like this Marvel dude.
You talking about Ghost Rider?
Ghost Rider. He did some type of shit like that when he sold his soul, so he become, because he was like a daredevil and shit.
Right,
so
become immortal.
Yeah, become immortal or some shit like that. So he sold his soul to the devil and shit. Like, right. Crazy shit, but you don't got to sell your soul to the devil. You
know? Right, but it's like a soul contract. Basically, what I'm saying, like, you ain't selling your soul to the devil. I know some people, oh my God. Nah, it's like, it ain't even that. It's like, you make a deal with the Most High. Like, when you get on this planet, you basically making a deal. Like, so everything you go through in your life, you've signed a contract to agree to that, to come back. Like, okay, so, like, for example, like, I'm gonna say me, like, the stuff I go through or the stuff I've been through, that you can't, like, basically, like, if you kill yourself, you basically failed your contract, because you couldn't deal with the stuff that you agreed to deal, that you was gonna deal with. So, like, for me, for example, like, all the bad stuff I used to go through, I had to go through that just to become the person I am today, and I had to go through that because that's the contract I signed before I came back on this planet. Like, you're going to have to go through this, you're going to have to go through that. And you don't have to accept it, because if you don't accept it, then you might come back as another person. You get what I'm saying? So it's like, then you make a deal with the demons, or let's say, like, the lower vibrational entities, to do, like, you have to, like, stay on your path. So basically what I'm saying is, like, when you make a deal with the demons, you're basically saying to the demons that you're going to stay on your path, and you're going to do what you're supposed to do. If you don't, then they'll be able to take over you. They'll be able to control you. So basically, they're trying to tell you, like, we can't touch you, because they can't touch you unless you allow them to touch you. But they're basically saying, if you don't do what you're supposed to do, like, for example, I'm here to do art, express my message, and save people through art. And anything can be art. Like I said, cooking, painting, banging on the table, anything can be art. And now, if I don't stay on that path, demons can be able to touch me, because it's like a contract I made with them. Like, you, for example, like, whatever your talent is, like, you can have, anybody can have a strong suit. You're supposed to stay on that path. If you don't, the demons can be able to touch you. That's for anybody. If you're into dancing, yep. If you're into anything like that, like, if you're into dancing, if you're into, shit, you're into stripping, whatever your talent is, if you don't stick to that, the demons can get you, because that's the contract you signed with them. But you signed a contract with the Most High to do good, too.
Yeah, so basically what you're saying is, like, if, like, what you're here to do on Earth, and if you don't do it, the demons gonna, like, put, like, obstacles in your way to, like, try to fuck with you. Like, say you might, like, you crossing the street and a light can be red, but a car still, still try to go past a red light, you almost get hit, like, giving you them signs and shit. Like, you better keep on going on your right track and, like, shit like that.
It's called crossroads. So, like, right now, December, like, I don't know, like, before I get into that, I ain't trying to, like, switch it up, but, like, I'm gonna stay on crossroads. I gotta remember that. Basically, like, it's December, right? 2014, but it's really 2007. Ethiopian time. People, if you don't know what I'm saying, get your knowledge up. Because we really on an illusional time. But anyway, it's like this, right? You could manifest anything in this world right now, because 2014 is the year for manifestation. So once December passes and it's January, it's not going to be really 2015. It's really going to be 2007 still. But Gregorian kind of going to be 2015. Your manifestation, you can get anything in this world right now while it's still December, because 2014 is the year to manifest. You don't spoil the wish, you pull the will it to existence. Me, the way I do it, say it 13 times, blah, blah, blah. But, like I was saying, crossroads. If you, like, let's say, for example, like, you're on your crossroad. Let's say you walk in your path of spirituality. You're doing right, right? You're eating right. You're doing everything right. Let's say somebody from your past come back in your life. And that could be a demon in disguise trying to hold you back. That's a crossroads. Knowing you don't want to do something, but something tempting you to do it, that's crossroads. You don't put it across your will. You know what I'm saying? That's how demons can get you, too. Like you said, you might get hit by a cop if you was crossing your, you was crossing the line. You was doing something you, you really want to do.
Some people might paint like, why is my ex just popped up out of nowhere? Yeah. Shit like that.
Demons,
like,
in disguise.
Yeah.
Because somebody trying to get you to do something that you don't want to do. You know how you be timid. You be like, I could do this.
Yeah.
But then you be like, I shouldn't. That's crossing your will. You don't supposed to do that. That's how they can get you. Because you not doing what you supposed to do. A lot of people not going to remember, like, they contrast because you got access to Akashic Records. We finna drop a video on that too, Akashic Records. But I'm just saying, like, demons is out here. They can get you. In order to get rid of demons, eat right, take a salt bath, burn some sage, chant whatever you want to chant, get your frequency up, stay out the sun, you know what I'm saying? Speak good things into existence.
Just have good, positive vibes, man. Like, don't be all, like, angry or all dull all every time. Because when you're angry and dull and depressed all day, that's what you're going to be every day. Depressed. That's who you're going to attract, is depressed people, angry people, shit like that.
Law of attraction. Mm. Like, before I end this video, it's like, you ever thought about it? Like you ever peeped it out as a kid or, like, as an adult? Because I ain't going to lie, a lot of these adults is crusty. Like, people keep saying kids don't really know what they're doing. Yeah. Kids know what they're doing because they just came back from the spirit realm. Kids are smart as fuck.
Yeah.
But adults is crusty because they into this illusional world. They got to work, slave, and die.
Yeah.
And they want to put that on their kids. You better slave, you better die, blah, blah, blah. But kids be knowing what they're doing because they got so much power. That's why school is built to steal your imagination.
Yeah.
People think it's a joke. They don't teach no imaginative shit. I don't know if that's a word, but they don't teach no type of shit with imagination in school. Except for art class. But they barely do that in art class. Right. In art, they teaching people how to twerk. Like, what the fuck? That's not even art.
What, a hypocrite?
Nah, not a hypocrite. I'm just saying, like, it'd be reports. Like, you look it up, it's like some art school teaching kids how to twerk or some shit like that. I'm like, what type of shit is that?
Yeah, that's shit crazy. On little cool bullshit.
But yeah, people, if you want to get rid of demons, just eat right. Like I said, the way demons can get you is fear. That's the biggest thing they can get you. Because fear is like a scent that leaves off your body and attracts them. Because fear is like demons, aphrodisiac. They attract you to that. That turns them on. Anything you want to say? Can you end this?
Nah, I'm good.